Sacramento to a much and against a much improved Sacramento Kings squad. De'Aaron Fox leading the way. I expect him to compete for an All-Star spot this year.
Who's that?
De'Aaron Fox.
I agree. He was in the discussion last year. He had an outstanding season. I love watching the Kings because of their announcer. They got a pretty good announcer. I love that guy. Carmelo Anthony. For those of you that don't know, Mark Jones is the announcer. Does an incredible job for Sacramento Kings. Nice, exciting squad up there in Northern California.
You were supposed to say that. You were supposed to say thank you.
Thank you, Mark.
Trying to play it off a little bit.
17-point lead. Was it a foul?
Yeah, but when you think about it, we're talking about Sacramento right now in the Western Conference. A team that kind of fits into that 7-8 spot, maybe, or the play-in tournament is back again, Mark. And I love the fact that the play-in tournament is back this year. It proved to be really compelling and riveting last year with some of the games we had with Golden State and Memphis. And I mean, I love the format that they're going to keep this year. And we'll have it in both the Eastern and the Western Conference.
It really did prove to be effective and successful. It made it very entertaining across the league. Even the, you know, closing out the season, games that wouldn't have been important, all of a sudden, they were playing for something. So it was fun to watch.
Of course, Frank Vogel's Lakers, if they're in the play-in tournament, that's not a good year for them.
Amen. It's not where they want to be.
Cam Johnson with the mid-range jump shot. Had a chance to speak with him prior to the game tonight. Went back to Pittsburgh to spend a little time there with some family and work on his game down in North Carolina, Chapel Hill, where he attended college. I asked him what it expects to translate into. He said he wants to be a lot more dynamic off the dribble this year. Like right there with a nice pass to JaVale McGee.
And I think he's going to make a jump in his play. His mentality should be, I'm a start in this league. He should be starting and impacting games. He does off the bench, but the next level is for him capitalizing and showing that he belongs and deserves to play extended minutes.
Smith missing the 15-footer. The Suns had the second best record in the NBA last year. Carmelo Anthony not trying to hear any of that. That's his fifth three of the night. He's got 17. Smith with the rebound, battling Rondo. Lakers down by 18. A rolling, sweeping hook that would make Kareem proud by JaVale McGee. We saw a little highlight of a junior hook a moment ago. Melo, McGee at the defensive boards.
You're right. In L.A., a great shot by Magic Johnson in the Boston Garden, the sky hook. But Kareem was wide open underneath the hoop.
Why are you trying to ruin a good story?
I'm saying, I was shocked at that one. I've been watching it for years.
McGee was open underneath and took the high handoff from Payne. The lead back up to 22. Rondo snakes off the screen. Nothing but Phoenix jerseys for that rebound. And Payne walks it into the front court. Two-second difference between shot and game clock.
I'm sorry, one advantage that Monty Williams has, he's not trying to find anything. He has all the answers. Now it's just about getting guys in shape and being healthy. But they have, you know, the recipe for success in Phoenix.
Payne with that nice float game. Melo gets it off in time. And that's the end of the third quarter play. Carmelo is 17, but Phoenix with a big lead. JaVale McGee with that sweeping sky hook. That's not sacrilege to say it in
don't,
here.
Don't you do that.
Okay.
Don't you compare it.
It looks similar.
Leave the cap alone. Leave the cap alone.